Mario, pre teba špecifický zápas, hral si proti svojmu bývalému týmu. Ako by si zhodnotil tento zápas?
Tak na tento zápas som sa veľmi tešil tým, že v tom týme Michaloviec je naozaj veľa chalanov, s ktorými som v podstate celý minulý rok hrával a veľmi som sa na tento zápas tešil.
Nakoniec sa ti podarilo aj gólovo presadiť, ako veľmi rád si a ako si videl tú situáciu gólovú?
Tak som veľmi rád naozaj, že mi to tam padlo. Teší to aj tým, že naozaj proti takému mužstvu, ako sú Michalovce, mi to tam padlo a bola to taká situácia, že signalizovaný trest, hrali sme v podstate skoro o dvoch hráčov viac, lebo už sme hrali presilovku a udržali sme sa dobre na puku a vlastne Jonas mi to pekne tam hodil a ja som v podstate už dával do prázdnej brány.
V čom bol podľa teba tento zápas iný oproti tomu v Bratislave?
Tak hlavne tým, že sme robili tie malé veci a tie detaily lepšie, ako sme robili v tej Bratislave a hlavne sme dohrávali veľa súbojov a nenechali sme sa v podstate tak byť, ako sme sa nechali v Bratislave a bol to väčšinou tých detailov, ktoré sme robili lepšie ako v ten zápas predtým.
Ako veľmi vás potrápili Michalovce?
Tak určite majú veľmi kvalitný tím a naozaj budú veľmi konkurenčne schopní tento rok v tej extralíge a som ďačný za to, že sa v podstate dostali do extralígy a teším sa na každý zápas s nimi.
Adam, tak ako by si zhodnotil dnešné víťazstvo?
Tak ten zápas sa vyvíjal viac menej, bolo to vyrovnané a v druhej tretine sme vlastne išli do vedenia, kde stále sme každým striedaním sme zlepšovali náš výkon a držali sme to skôr a nakoniec sa nám podarilo vyhrať.
Tebe sa podarilo aj gólovo presadiť, ako si videl celú tú situáciu?
Tak držal som tam dlhšie puk na palici a videl som voľný priestor, takže som neváhal a vyskúšal vystrieť, no a padlo to tam.
A v čom bol možno tento zápas iný ako ten v Bratislave?
No určite cítiť rozdiel plochy, keďže je tu väčšie ihrisko, ale na to, že sme hrali prvý zápas na väčšom ihrisku, tak myslím si, že z našej strany to nebolo zlé, ale vždy máme ešte veľa roboty pred sebou, čo musíme zlepšiť, ale ide to zo dňa na deň vždy lepšie a lepšie.
Akurát som chcel aj na to nadviazať, o pár dní sa tu predstavíme znovu na turnaji, takže čo dovtedy zlepšiť podľa teba?
Je toho určite viac a presne teraz neviem povedať, asi nevšimal som si to úplne všetko, ale určite budeme musieť viac komunikovať a ešte dotiahnuť nejaké veci v obranom pásme a v útočnom pásme a preslovky si myslím, že nám celkom išli dneska, takže.
OK, vďaka.
Second game of the preseason, so what can you say about it?
Yeah, we talked about improving on several things from last game, and that's what preseason's all about, just making small improvements every day in every game, and you know, we were a much better team today than we were 2 days ago, so our puck movement was better, our defensive play was better, so definitely seeing some steps forward.
I had a question about Jambrej Čak. He played here last two games, but he don't have a contract, I think.
So actually, that's I don't know really. That's a question for management. I think he's here. If he's signed or not, I'm not sure, but my understanding was that there was going to be an open contract and then he can leave, but for a higher league, but I'm not 100% sure where they are with that.
Beskovany played his first game. Do you like it?
Yeah, very, very much so. Very calm in there. You know, big guy, as we know, and just super, super calm in there. A lot of pucks hit him. He just got here on Wednesday, so we're on Tuesday in practice for the first time on Wednesday. So we weren't sure he was going to play the whole game. We were thinking maybe two periods, but he wanted to stay in there, and it's a good first game.
Mike McMurty and Eric Bartanos didn't play two games, so what is to them?
Mike had to go home for personal reasons. We don't have a resolution on that yet, so you know, we'll have to wait and see what happens there. And Bertie just has an illness that he needed some attention for, and he needs some rest. So hopefully he'll be back on the ice on Monday.
You had to change the lines after Hanka finished in game. So were you surprised after that, or was it big complication for you?
Well, it seemed kind of like we were on our heels to start the second period after Hernets left there. Then the guys kind of got used to playing with different guys every shift. It was a little bit there was a little bit more to do on the bench there with different lines going out there a lot and a lot of special teams, but the guys handled it well, and I really liked our third period. Very in control and just making the safe and simple play every time.
A lot of PKs again. Was it better tonight?
Still a few reaching penalties. I thought we were a little bit better at taking penalties. Our PK was excellent, thankfully, much better. That was another thing we talked about. We looked a lot at video of our PK, and it was much better today.
Two young defensemen have scored goals, so are you happy for them?
Yeah, Rasanen made a nice... He's well-schooled. You can see that he plays the game with a lot of technical ability. He is in the right places a lot, so he jumped up there, and that was also our fourth line guys that created that. Soika took a hit to make a play. Lunter had some good speed out of the zone, and then Willy and Gertzel went to the net, and Rasanen followed it up. So it was a good play all around. And Jacques is going to be a very good player for us, and definitely in the future he's going to be he's a rising star, so I'm really happy with how he's playing so far.
We're playing in here in a few days, so what should we do better?
We just got to keep being better at the small things. Our passing was still a bit off, so we just got to keep working on our passing, on our support on the puck. That was a big thing in the first game that we didn't do well, was support the puck well, and we were better today, but we keep getting better at that. Our PP can be better as well, but pretty much everything in the game can continue to improve, but that's just a day-by-day thing.
Will Hrnka be okay, or you don't know yet?
Don't know yet. It's nothing. It doesn't seem like it's anything serious. We just tweaked something in his lower body, but we wanted to be very careful. But we'll see on Monday how he looks. Yeah. Well, it's extremely frustrating that we have to practice on a practice rink. For all the way so far for 3 weeks, and with no end really in sight, it's extremely frustrating. Especially since no real work is being done in our normal rink. It just doesn't seem. It's confusing. It's three-time defending champions we are. And we have to go represent, not only Banská Bystrica but Slovakia against some of the best teams in Europe. And we're practicing right now on a rink that we have to stop practice because it gets so foggy. It's a tiny little rink. It's hard to work on the things we want to work on. And we are really looking forward to practicing on a proper ice rink, but. I don't know when that's going to happen. All summer this rink sat there, empty, no work being done on it. And, it's extremely frustrating for the players and coaching staff. We're coming to the rink every day trying to work and get better. It's just a difficult situation. So hopefully that can be resolved soon so we can get practicing and, be able to get our best effort going against, Champions Hockey League teams that are some of the best teams in Europe. So, hopefully that can be resolved soon.